A new play by one of the nation's leading playwrights, who's known for his domestic dramas, asks the question, what makes us, us? Jeffrey Brown went to Chicago, where his latest play opened this weekend, to find out.
That's not what your father wants.
11 scenes that capture the life of one woman from infancy to age 69. But it's told out of chronological order, and she's played by six different actresses.
I am unexceptional.
Mary Page Marlowe, the new play by Tracy Letts, is just now opening.
It sounds different every time you do it.
But when I visited in early March, rehearsals had just begun.
You're always doing it.
And when I said it was odd to be there talking about a play I hadn't seen, Letts reminded me of something rather important if you happen to be the playwright.
I haven't seen it either.
You haven't seen it either. Do you know what you have at this point?
You know, normally at this point you have a pretty good sense of what you have, but Mary Page Marlowe is an unusual piece. The non-linear narrative, the different women playing the character. I think I know what we've got, but until there's an audience in the room, I won't really know.
You remember he used to just take off, no call, nothing?
Letts, now 50, is best known for the Tony and Pulitzer Prize-winning play, August, Osage County, later made into a film.
Our kid is trying to deal with this madhouse you dragged her into.
It tells of an Oklahoma family, as a New York Times review put it, in near-apocalyptic meltdown of dysfunctional behavior.
There are, believe me, easier things in this world.
Letts is also an acclaimed actor. He won a Tony Award in 2013 for his role in another famous dysfunctional relationship drama, Edward Albee's Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf. More recently, he starred in the TV drama Homeland.
I would have come earlier. I was in a marathon meeting with my lawyers.
And the film The Big Short.
The housing market is rock solid.
The new play has its own share of unruly behavior, but its focus is the deep subject of identity.
It's hard for you to see it. Now, this is sad, and it's not the way that we wanted it.
If you sit at all in the question of what makes you you, and you start to ask yourself, is it my parents, my background, my geographical background, my age, my gender? What are the things that make you you?
We pretend that I'm making decisions about the direction of my life. I'm not. I haven't.
Letts says he was inspired to write the play after the death of his mother 18 months ago.
You spend a lot of time in reflection about your parents' life, their journey. Mary Page Marlowe is not my mother, though she's inspired by my mother, and she's inspired by the idea that we are different people at different points in our life. In fact, my 17-year-old self would not recognize the man I am now.
Really?
And I don't recognize him much either.
So that makes life a constant surprise, right?
Maybe it speaks to something in me. I've some searching in me. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I know that I'm a hell of a lot more comfortable at 50, comfortable with who I am, than I was with myself at 30 or at 17.
The monologue, I'm still working.
Some of the comfort clearly comes from his long association with Chicago's Steppenwolf Theater Company, a renowned incubator with an ensemble of writers and actors who've had a major influence on the world of American theater and beyond.
I can afford to take chances. I can afford to make a fool of myself.
They'll keep you around anyway.
They'll keep me around anyway, and they'll tell me. They'll tell me to my face, you didn't get this right.
Here are a couple things that I think might help.
One of those truth tellers is longtime friend and collaborator Anna Shapiro, who's directed numerous plays at Steppenwolf and on Broadway, and was recently named the company's artistic director.
And
she's now taken on Mary Page Marlowe.
Have a really inappropriate response.
The first big challenge of this play, Shapiro said, was to make sure that a story that jumps around chronologically didn't feel out of order.
You just have to kind of expand your definition of what is chronology. I'm not sure life is happening in order anyway.
Yeah, the way a life unfolds and
the way life feels, the way life feels. I think when you get older, and I think Tracy and I are getting a little bit older, you do start to understand the kind of inevitable arbitrariness of life. And it feels unrelentingly arbitrary.
Really? You don't know?
We watched an early rehearsal in which Mary Page, at age 36, is talking to her therapist. She's played by Tracy Letts' wife, Carrie Coon. During a key monologue, director Anna Shapiro was bothered.
But my ear is jumping at someone called.
After some discussion, the playwright came up with a new line.
I just found out my college girlfriend, Lorna, died from breast cancer last month, and I'm sitting here talking about compartments.
That's awesome.
The tweaking, Letts told me later at his home as he and Coon made dinner, would continue.
Every time I write a new play, we sit down, we read the thing, and the fear is that people are going to say, this is garbage, and they're going to take it, and they're going to throw it away, and say, you've done something just terrible. The hope is that they're going to carry me out of the theater on their shoulders and carry me down the street saying, he's a genius. But the reality is that good, smart people working around me say, okay, let's get to work.
Letts and Coon met as actors in Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf.
It's really hard to find good roles for women, and my husband happens to be one of those people that's actually writing roles that dignify women because he deeply respects them. And everybody in his plays, they're all in there somewhere, you know, all the people. So I feel like I'm married to a lot of people. It's exciting. It's never boring.
A nice domestic scene with a playwright renowned for the very opposite. So where does all that dysfunction come from?
It's drama. It's, you know, if I just wrote about the healthy side of myself, it wouldn't be very interesting or dramatic.
A married couple makes alu gobi in the kitchen.
Doesn't make for a great scene.
He cuts the potatoes too small. She's irritated, but she doesn't say anything.
Not great theater, perhaps, but a fine dinner. From Chicago, I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.